tiny question.
Yeah.
As early as, you know, as recently as today, someone said to me about Constantine. I don't know why he keeps popping up. They say,
yeah,
well, he chopped it up and he made it up whatever he wanted. So
yeah,
I don't know, his name keeps popping up. So what can I say? Practically, you can say that Constantine edited it so he could have,
sure,
make it his way. So.
Well, I guess you could just say, unless Constantine went back in time and produced manuscripts, that's the only plausible explanation. I mean, we have hundreds of manuscripts that predate Constantine. So it's ludicrous to say that he somehow controlled the text of the Bible when we can reconstruct the text of the Bible prior to Constantine. Like, Constantine certainly had, I would say, zero influence on the text of the Bible, even its canon. The Council of Nicaea, if you actually read the canons of the Council of Nicaea, it says nothing about the extent of the canon. That never comes up there. So this idea that somehow it was kind of decided on what books to include in the Council of Nicaea is basically totally unhistorical. I mean, there's no evidence for that whatsoever. The only time I've heard that is from Dan Brown or someone else saying that. But I mean, yeah, if you just look at the evidence, the manuscripts available prior to Constantine, the fact that none of the decrees of the Council of Nicaea had anything to do with the canon, the fact that the translation of the Bible into all those different languages preceding, you have the Coptic, the Syriac, you have the early Latin Bible, you have Armenian translations. All of these are ancient translations that were outside of the influence of Constantine, prior to him even existing. And if you trace back their history, you can see that the text hasn't been corrupted. So there really wasn't any kind of conspiracy for that at all. It's very unhistorical. Close.
Quickly tell us, what was that language you showed in the beginning?
Oh yeah, very good.
Oh, yeah.
And then close in prayer. I'm dying, you know.
See,
I've been wiggling in my sleep. It's not Ethiopian.
Is called Cyrillic, as of Saint Cyril, but he actually didn't have anything to do with the Cyrillic alphabet. It comes from the Greek. This is the alphabet he produced, and it's no longer used, so it's a very ancient Russian language. With that, dear Heavenly Father, we thank you so much for your word, and we just see from the example of your son how often he drew on scripture for the teaching and the admonishing of people. And I pray, Lord, you would give us no less of a respect and a desire to learn from the Bible. And I just thank you for it. I thank you for the access that you have, the freedom, for the work of so many godly men through the ages, Lord. And we thank you for their efforts. And I just pray that you would just really give us a heart for your word, that we'd love it, that we'd seek to understand it and live it, Lord, and that it would just be part of our daily walk with you, that we would let it wash over us. And I do pray, Lord, you would give us opportunities to graciously, Lord, just share some of the things we've learned about the history of the Bible, and maybe, Lord, show people that the criticisms so often are based on lies, really, more than bad methodologies. And I just thank you, Lord, for the Bible. I thank you for it. And thank you for the freedom we have. I pray that we would use this time of freedom wisely and that we do not go slack, Lord. Thank you in Jesus' name. Amen. Amen. So guys, there are the outlines here for the Bible in Europe. And I do encourage you all to do it.
Thank you for our visitors and our members. It's good to have all you here. We want you to stay as long as you can. Drink as much coffee or tea as you like, and eat as many chocolate cupcakes as
you
want.
Thank you.